بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. In the last several talks concerning the discussion by Sheikh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah on his classical book, The Correct Response to Those Who Altered the Religion of Isa alayhi salam, the last points he made are illustrated to this effect, that the verses of the sword did not abrogate the verses regarding da'wah and establishing the evidences. You understand? This is what was discussed in what, almost three consecutive talks. Is that clear? So this is the take-home message which we learned from these three discussions, right? You remember that now? And from this point also, which he discussed, we knew that da'wah was given to Christians, right? And that the da'wah that was given to the Christians from Najran in the south of Arabia, right, that took place even after the revelation of the verse of the sword. You understand? So the Prophet ﷺ, therefore, was giving da'wah to non-Arabs, right? Remember, in the very beginning of the response, the point is that the Christian monk or the priest was making, the point that he was making is that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was only sent to the Arabs. And Shaykh al-Islam rahimahullah began refuting that. And from the things that he came to mention is that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave da'wah to non-Arabs. And from them also were those Christians of the south of Najran. Then he came across the misconception that the verses of the sword abrogated the verses of da'wah. And he, over a course of, which took us about two, three lectures, he gave evidences and proofs to the contrary. To the contrary. Now, he continues now on this, continuing on this point about the da'wah. He said, rahimahullah, and before the story of Najran, many of the Jews and the Christians believed in him and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In fact, some of their leaders and other than their leaders, when it became apparent to them that he is Rasulullah ilayhim, that he is the messenger of Allah sallallahu, the messenger of Allah to them. As, then he comes now what to tell us, as the belief of An-Najashi, the king of Abyssinia, as in the case of the king of Abyssinia, An-Najashi. And he was, like his people, were Christians, were Nasara. And the belief of An-Najashi took place at the very beginning of the time of prophethood, at the time when the companions of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam were persecuted in Mecca, and the kafirs harmed them and punished them for their belief in Allah and his messenger. So a group of them migrated to Al-Habasha, to Abyssinia, and from them a group like Uthman bin Affan radiyallahu anhu and Abdul Rahman bin Auf al-Qurashi, one of the ten given the glad tidings of paradise, attaining paradise, and one of the six whom the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam died while pleased with them. He accepted Islam early, and he migrated, the two migrations, and he attended the Battle of Badr, and all the other battles. And he spent of his wealth in the cause of Allah. And he died in the year 32 after Hijrah. So, okay, Shaykh al-Islam is naming them, and we're trying to give some biography on some of them. Abd al-Rahman bin Auf, now you know who is he. And also from them is Az-Zubayr bin al-Awwam. Az-Zubayr bin al-Awwam, al-Qurashi, al-Asadi, also accepted Islam early and migrated the two migrations. And he attended all the battles. And he is one of the 10 al-Ashara al-Mubashareen bil-Jannah, given tidings of paradise. And one of the 6. What does it mean, one of the 6? Huh? I'm asking you now. The 6, yes, whom the Prophet died while pleased with them, exactly. Naam, naam. Yes. Az-Zubayr ibn al-Awwam. And he was the first to raise the sword in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it is reported in Al-Bukhari and Muslim that he is Hawari Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that he is a disciple of the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam. And he was martyred in the battle of, or on the day of Al-Jamal in the year 36 after Hijrah radiallahu anhu. And from those also who migrated to Abyssinia, Abdullah bin Mas'ud. Abdullah bin Mas'ud. Abdullah bin Mas'ud bin Ghafil al-Hudali. He accepted Islam early. And he migrated the two migrations. And he attended all the battles. And he was with the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in his company for a long time. And he related many narrations from the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. And he was one of the faqih, كان فقيها rather, from فقهاء الصحابة. He was one of the scholars of the scholars amongst the companions. And he was also a reciter. And he has the recitation of Abdullah bin Mas'ud. And one of the 10 and one of the 6. And his merits are many. He died in 32 after Hijrah in Medina. And from them also, Ja'far bin Abi Talib. Oh, may Allah be pleased with all of them. And others from men and women. They migrated to the land of Abyssinia. To the king, to the just king of Abyssinia. So the Kafirs of Quraysh, they sent after them their messengers with gifts to Abyssinia's king and to his bishops. Why? In order what? In order to send them back to Quraysh so that they punish them. Naam. And because he was a just man and king, ruler, he did not accept sending them back until he listens to their story. When he listened to them and they told him from the matter of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he accepted and he believed in the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam, and he hosted them. And when he heard the Quran, he said, إِنَّ هَذَا وَالَّذِي جَاءَ بِهِ مُوسَى لَيَخْرُجُ مِنْ مِشْكَاتٍ وَاحِدًا. This, the Quran, and that which Musa brought, comes from the same source. And when he asked them regarding what they say about Isa alayhi salam, they said, نَشْهَدُ أَنَّهُ عَبْدُ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولُ, that he is the slave of Allah and his messenger. وَكَلِمَتُهُ أَلْقَاهَا إِلَى مَرْيَمُ, and his word which he bestowed on Mary, the virgin, whom no man has ever touched. So Al-Najashi said to one of the migrating companions, Ja'far bin Abi Talib رضي الله عنه, that what the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم brought and Isa عليه السلام brought was on the same, was on the same message. So his bishops fretted and fumed and snorted, and he said, even if you do so. And he sent his son and a group of his companions to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam with Ja'far bin Abi Talib. And Ja'far bin Abi Talib came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam in the year of Khaybar. And this story of the migration is mentioned by group of scholars and masters of hadith like Ahmad bin Hanbal in his Musnad, Ibn Sa'd in his Tabaqat, Abi Nu'aym in Al-Hiliyya, and others, and also mentioned by the people of tafsir and hadith and fiqh, and it is consecutive with many of the scholars. From the woman who migrated was Salama, Salama bint Abi Umayya bin Al-Mughira, the wife of the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. Salama, Hind bint Abi Umayya bin Al-Mughira Al-Makhzumiyya, Al-Mu'mineen, the mother of the believers. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم married her after Abi Salama. It was said the fourth or third year after Hijra. And she lived after that 60 years. She died in the year 62 after Hijra, رضي الله عنها. From amongst the immigrants, she, Salama, was one of them. And she reported, رضي الله عنها, she said, when we came to the land of Abyssinia, and we came to its king, Al-Najashi, we felt safe on our deen, and we worshipped Allah, and we were not harmed, and we didn't hear anything we disliked. So when Quraysh learned of this, they conspired. Well, they couldn't tolerate the prospect of a secure and safe place available for the Muslims in Abyssinia. So they dispatched two messengers to demand their expulsion. And they were Amr bin Al-As and Abdullah bin Abi Rabi'a. This is before they accepted Islam. And they took with them valuable gifts to the king and his clergy. And had been able to win some of the courtiers over their side. And these messengers of Quraysh claimed that the Muslim refuge should be expelled from Abyssinia and handed over to them on the ground that they had abandoned the religion of their forefathers, and their leader was preaching a religion different from theirs and from that of the king. So they brought an innovated religion, which is not known to us, and also not known to you, meaning you, the clergy of the king. So they suggested to the clergy that when we talk to the king, you suggest that we expel them and return them with us. Afterwards, they offered some of their valuable gifts to the Najashi, and he accepted it from them. Then they spoke to him, and they said, O king, he, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, brought a religion, left his religion of his forefathers, and some of his followers, some of his youth followers, foolish ones came to you, left the religion of their fathers, and they did not enter your religion. And they brought an innovative religion not known to us nor to you. And our dignitaries had sent us to you to expel them and return them with us. And she said, رحمة رضي الله عنها, nothing was more hated to Abdullah bin Abi Rabi'ah and to Amr ibn al-As more than the king, what? Listens to our story. So the clergy around him supported the statements of the Quraysh delegates, and they suggested to the king to return them to their people and to their land, to return the Muslim immigrants. She said, فَغَضِبَ النَّجَاشِي. غضب. And Najashi became angry. Then he swore, by Allah, no. I will not do that with people who came and took me for protection and came to my land and chose me over others. I will not do that before I speak to them and ask them regarding what you are saying. And if they are as what you are saying, then we will expel them and return them with you. And if they are not, we will prevent you from them and she said, the king summoned the Muslims to the court and asked them to explain the teachings of their religion. So they gathered together. They are determined to speak the truth before him. And he said to them, what is this religion that has caused you to separate from your people, to not enter my religion or any of those others? Of course, the clergy were there. So, who responded to the king? The one who responded to the king was Ja'far bin Abi Talib, may Allah be pleased with him, and he said, Ayyuhal Malik, O king, stood up and addressed the king in the following words, O king, we were an ignorant people. We worshipped idols, and we ate the meat of dead carcasses. We were accustomed to bad behavior, to severing the ties of kinship, neglecting our neighbors, and the strong among us consumed the weak. This is how we were. But then Allah sent a messenger to us. We were aware of his lineage, his truthfulness, that he was trustworthy and chaste. He began inviting us to Allah, that we single him out and that we worship him alone. So we left the religion of our forefathers that we had been previously following. We left the worship of stones and idols of all others besides Allah. He also commanded us to be truthful in our speech, fulfill trusts, nurture the ties of kinship, be kind to our neighbor, and to refrain from spilling blood unlawfully. He forbade us from bad behavior, from bad speech, from consuming the orphan's wealth, and from slandering chaste women. He commanded that we worship Allah alone, without associating anything with him. He commanded us to perform the prayer, give charity, and fast. So he listed the Islamic injunctions. And he continued. So we trusted him and believed in him and followed the religion of Allah that he delivered. We began to worship Allah alone. We would not associate anything with him, and we began prohibiting what he made unlawful for us. For this our people rose as enemies against us, punishing us, torturing us to get us to leave our religion and return to the worshipping idols instead of worshipping Allah. And they expected us to consider all of the filthy things lawful as we previously did. So when they overpowered us, oppressed us, and restricted us, when they came between us and our religion, then we came to your land. We chose you over others besides you, desiring to be your neighbor, and hoping that you, O King, will not wrong us. The Najashi Negus said, quote, "Is there any of this with you that he told you to be from Allah?" Ja'far said, "Yes." The Najashi, the Negus, said, "Then recite some of it for me." He recited the opening verses of Surah Maryam, chapter 19, verses the following: Kaf, Ha, Ya, Ayn, Sad. ذكر رحمة ربك عبده زكريا. كاف ها يا عين صاد. This is a mention of the mercy of your Lord to his slave زكريا when he called out his Lord a call in secret. إذ نادى ربه نداء خفيا قال ربي إني وهن العظم مني واشتعل الرأس شيبا ولم أك بدعائك ربي شقيا. Saying, "My Lord, indeed my bones have grown feeble and gray hair has spread on my head, and I have never been upset, unblessed in my invocation to you, O my Lord." وَإِنِّي خِفْتُ الْمَوَالِيَ مِنْ وَرَائِي وَكَانَتْ امْرَأَتِي عَاقِرًا فَهَبْ لِي مِنْ لَدُنْكَ وَلِيًّا. And verily I fear my relatives after me, since my wife is barren, so give me from yourself an heir. يرثني ويرث من آل يعقوب واجعله ربي رضيا. Who shall inherit me and inherit also the posterity of Yaqub, the inheritance of religious knowledge and prophethood, not the wealth of course. And make him my Lord, one with whom you are well pleased. يا زكريا إنا نبشرك بغلام اسمه يحيى لم نجعل له من قبل سميا. O Zakaria, verily we give you the glad tidings of a son. His name will be Yahya. We have given that name to none before him. قال ربي أن يكون لي غلام وكانت امرأتي عاقرا وقد بلغت من الكبر عتيا. He said, "My Lord, how can I have a son when my wife is barren? And I have reached the extreme old age." He said, قال كذلك قال ربك هو علي هين وقد خلقتك من قبل ولم تك شيئا. He said, "So it will be. Your Lord says it is easy for me. Certainly I have created you before when you had been nothing." قال رب اجعل لي آية. قال آيتك ألا تكلم الناس ثلاث ليال سويا. زكريا said, "My Lord, appoint for me a sign." He said, "Your sign is that you shall not speak unto mankind for three nights, though having no bodily defect." فخرج على قومه من المحراب فأوحى إليهم أن سبحوا بكرة وعشية. Then he came out to his people from Al-Mihrab, and he told them by signs to glorify Allah's praises in the morning and the afternoon. يا يحيى خذ الكتاب بقوة وآتيناه الحكم صبيا. It was said to his son, O Yahya, hold fast the scripture, meaning the Torah, and we gave him wisdom while yet a child. وحنانا من لدنا وزكاة وكان تقيا. And made him sympathetic to men as a mercy or a grant from us and pure from sins, meaning Yahya, and he was righteous. وبرا بوالديه ولم يكن جبارا عصيا, and dutiful towards his parents, and he was neither an arrogant nor disobedient to Allah or to his parents. وسلام عليه يوم ولد ويوم يموت ويوم يبعث حيا. And salam, peace and safety and security be on him the day he was born, and the day he dies, and the day he will be raised up to life again. واذكر في الكتاب مريم إذ انتبذت من أهلها مكانا شرقيا. And mention in the book, the Quran, or Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, the story of Maryam, Mary, when she withdrew in seclusion from her family to a place facing east. فاتخذت من دونهم حجابا فأرسلنا إليها روحنا فتمثل لها بشرا سويا. She placed a screen to screen herself from them. Then we sent to her our ruh, angel Jibril, Gabriel, and he appeared before her in the form of a man in all respects. فاتخذت من دونهم حجابا فأرسلنا إليها روحنا فتمثل لها بشرا سويا قالت إني أعوذ بالرحمن منك إن كنت تقيا. She said, verily I seek refuge with the most beneficent from you if you do fear Allah. قال إنما أنا رسول ربك لأهب لك غلاما زكيا. The angel said, I am only a messenger from your Lord to announce to you the gift of a righteous son. قالت أن يكون لي غلام ولم يمسسني بشر ولم أكو بغية. She said, how can I have a son when no man has touched me nor I am unchaste? قال كذلك قال ربك هو علي هين ولنجعله آية للناس ورحمة منا وكان أمرا مقضيا. He said, so it will be, your Lord said, that is easy for me, and we wish to appoint him as a sign to mankind and a mercy from us, and it is a matter already decreed by Allah. فحملته فانتبذت به مكانا قصيا. So she conceived him and she withdrew with him to a far place, Bethlehem Valley, about 4 to 6 miles from Jerusalem. فأجاءها المخاض إلى جذع النخلة قالت يا ليتني مت قبل هذا وكنت نسيا منسيا. And the pains of childbirth drove her to the trunk of a date palm. She said, would that I had died before this and had been forgotten and out of sight. فناداها من تحتها ألا تحزني قد جعل ربك تحتك سريا. Then he, the babe, Isa or Jibril, cried unto her from below her saying, grieve not, your Lord has provided a water stream under you. وهزي إليك بجذع النخلة تساقط عليك رطبا جنيا. And shake the trunk of the palm towards you, it will let fall fresh ripe dates upon you. فكلي واشربي وقري عينا فإما ترين من البشر أحدا فقولي إني نظرت للرحمن صوما فلن أكلم اليوم إنسيا. So eat and drink and be glad, and if you see any human being say, verily I have vowed a fast unto the most beneficent, so I shall not speak to any human being this day. فأتت به قومها تحمله قالوا يا مريم لقد جئت شيئا فريا. Then she brought him the baby to her people carrying him. They said, O Mary, indeed you have brought a thing, an unheard mighty thing. يا أخت هارون ما كان أبوك امرأ سوء وما كانت أمك بغية. O sister, the like of Harun, not the brother of Musa. He was another pious man at that time. O sister, the like of Harun, your father was not a man who used to commit adultery, nor your mother was an unchaste woman. فأشارت إليه قالوا كيف نكلم من كان في المهد صبيا. Then she pointed to him. They said, "How can we talk to one who is a child in the cradle?" قال إني عبد الله آتاني الكتاب وجعلني نبيا. He Isa said, "Verily, I am the slave of Allah. He has given me the scripture and made me a prophet." الله أكبر. وجعلني مباركا أينما كنت وأوصاني بالصلاة والزكاة ما دمت حيا. And he has made me blessed wherever I be, wheresoever I be, and has enjoined on me salah and zakah as long as I live. وبرّم بوالدتي ولم يجعلني جبارا شقيا and dutiful to my mother and made me not arrogant unblessed. والسلام علي يوم ولدت ويوم أموت ويوم أبعث حيا and salam be upon me the day I was born and the day I die and the day I shall be raised alive. ذلك عيسى بن مريم قول الحق الذي فيه يمترون. Such is Isa, Jesus, son of Maryam, Mary. It is a statement of truth about which they doubt or dispute. ما كان لله أن يتخذ من ولد سبحانه إذا قضى أمرا فإنما يقول له كن فيكون. It befits not the majesty of Allah that he should beget a son. Glorified. And exalted be he above all that they associate with him. When he decrees a thing, he only says to it be, and it is. وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ رَبِّي وَرَبُّكُمْ فَاعْبُدُوهُ هَذَا صِرَاطٌ مُسْتَقِيمٌ. And verily, Allah is my Lord and your Lord, so worship him alone. That is the straight path, Allah's religion of Tawheed, of Islamic monotheism, which he had ordained for all of his prophets. فَاخْتَلَفَ الْأَحْزَابُ مِنْ بَيْنِهِمْ فَوَيْلٌ لِلَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مِنْ مَشْهَدِ يَوْمٍ عَظِيمٍ. Then the sects differ, meaning the Christians, about Isa, about Jesus. So woe unto the disbelievers, those who gave false witness by saying that Jesus is the Son of Allah from the meeting of a great day, meaning the day of resurrection, when they'll be thrown in the blazing fire. أسمع بهم وأبصر يوم يأتوننا لكن الظالمون اليوم في ضلال مبين. How clearly will they, the polytheists and disbelievers in the oneness of Allah, see and hear the day when they will appear before us. But the ظالمين, the polytheists and the oppressors, the unjust and wrongdoers today are in plain error. وأنذرهم يوم الحسرة إذ قضي الأمر وهم في غفلة وهم لا يؤمنون. إنا نحن نرث الأرض ومن عليها وإلينا يرجعون. And warn them, O Muhammad, صلى الله عليه وسلم, of the day of grief and regrets when the case has been decided, while now they are in a state of carelessness and they believe not. إنا نحن نرث الأرض ومن عليها وإلينا يرجعون. Verily, we will inherit the earth and whatsoever is thereupon, and to us they all shall be returned. Verily, we will inherit the earth, and whatsoever is thereon, and to us they all shall be returned. قالت أم سلمة, أم سلمة said, رضي الله عنها, فبكى, فبكى. So he cried, he moved to tears. والله, by Allah he cried, النجاشي حتى خضل لحيته. He moved to tears that rolled down his cheeks and even wet his beard. وَبَكَتْ أَسَاقِفَتُهُ. So his clergy also cried. Here, the Najashi, the Negus, said, إِنَّ هَذَا وَالَّذِي جَاءَ بِهِ مُوسَى لَيَخْرُجُ مِنْ مِشْكَاتٍ وَاحِدًا. It seems as if these words and those which were revealed to Moses or to Jesus are the rays of the light which have, or are from the same source. So then he, afterwards he said to Abdullah bin Abi Rabi'ah and Amr ibn al-As, the delegates of Quraysh, go ahead, go. By Allah, I will not surrender them to you. Never. After that, the next day, the two messengers of Quraysh again went to the king and said that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his followers blasphemed Jesus. So again, the next day, the Muslims were summoned and asked what they thought of Jesus. And Ja'far radiallahu anhu, Ja'far bin Abi Talib again stood up and replied, "We speak about Jesus as we have been taught by our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That is, he is the servant and the slave of Allah, his messenger. His spirit, which Allah bestowed on Mary, a created spirit meaning, and his word, be, which he breathed into Virgin Mary." The king remarked that they believed the same. Ameen and you too. The king remarked that they believed the same. Then turning to the frowning members of the delegation and to his bishops who got angry, he mentioned that they may fret and fume as they like, but Jesus was nothing more than what Ja'far, may Allah be pleased with him, has said about him. And then afterwards he then assumed the Muslims of full protection, and he returned to the delegation of Quraysh the gifts they had brought with him, with them, and sent them away. And the Muslims lived in Abyssinia undisturbed for a number of years in good company. Then she mentioned, radiallahu anha, "We stayed in this state of security until someone came to dispute the Abyssinian king for his kingdom." She said, "Then we feared so much that this disputant will prevail over the Najashi, and then comes another one who does not know of our rights like what al-Najashi knew." And then they made dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give al-Najashi victory upon his enemy, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him victory against his enemy, and al-Najashi prevailed and Allah destroyed his enemy. And she said, "We were so pleased." And in the Sahihain in al-Bukhari and Muslim, from the hadith of Abi Musa, he said, "We got the news of the migration of the Prophet while we were in Yemen. So we set out migrating to him. We were, I and my two brothers, I being the youngest, and one of my brothers was Abu Burda, and the other was Abu Ruhm. We were over 50 or 53 or 52 men from our people. We got on board a ship which took us to al-Najashi in Ethiopia, in Abyssinia. And there we found Ja'far bin Abi Talib, remember? And his companions with al-Najashi, with Negus. Ja'far said to us, 'Allah's messenger has sent us here and ordered us to stay here, so you too stay with us.' We stayed with them till we all left Abyssinia and met the Prophet ﷺ at the time when he had conquered Khaybar." Khaybar, this was the place of the Jews. "He gave us a share from its booty," or gave us from its booty. "He gave only to those who had taken part in the ghazwa, in the conquest, with him. But he did not give any share to any person who had not participated in Khaybar's conquest, except the people of our ship, besides Ja'far and his companions, whom he gave a share as he did them," meaning the people of the ship. Then afterwards, al-Najashi Negus died, and the Prophet ﷺ informed of his death to his companions on the same day. On the same day when he died, and he said, "Istaghfiru li akhikum," seek Allah's forgiveness for your brother. And this is in al-Bukhari and Muslim. Then he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, left to the praying place, Yes, yes, of course. استغفروا لأخيكم. Seek forgiveness for your brother, he said. He then left to the musalla, and the companions took lines behind him, and he salla alayhi. He offered the funeral prayer on him, وكبر أربع تكبيرات, and made four takbirs. So he prayed on him, the funeral prayer in absentia. And this is in Sahih al-Bukhari and Sahih Muslim. May Allah's mercy be upon al-Najashi, and may Allah reward him abundantly for his great stance with the Muslims. Yeah. This brings the end of this part, and this is part 14. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make this of benefit for myself and for all of you. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا.